These kids and their teachers have worked very hard to put on this show for you, so we're so glad that we have a full house tonight to show off for you. So thanks for coming. I do want to ask before I forget if you have a flash on your camera, if you wouldn't mind turning your flash off really quickly. We want you to take as many pictures as you would like, but we don't want to distract the kids with the flashes. So if you wouldn't mind turning those off, that would be awesome. And one more thing before I forget, this is not a traditional recital where the curtains will close each time. So a lot of the program, the curtains will stay open between dances. But we do want to make sure that you guys clap after every performance. It's important for the kids to know that you're all here and you're watching them and you're supporting them. So cheer and clap loudly for them and let them know that you appreciate their hard work to that, okay? I just wanted to get started by letting you know that this is called Elemental, and we're glad that you came. I'm going to begin by introducing some of our dance instructors. They're going to be opening the show, and we have four special help assistant teachers that I would like to introduce to you so that you can put a little bit of a name with a face when you see them. One of our instructors is Ian Sweet. He came to us from Oklahoma. He's actually our newest dance instructor at Rock Solid. He's just been with the kids for about 2 to 3 months, and he's been dancing his whole life since he was two. He has been to LA and Vegas and on the New York stage and has a lot of dance experience. If you guys have heard of a show called So You Think You Can Dance, he was actually on that. So that's super cool. So when you see Ian, he's kind of like cool like that. Miss Jordan Dane, this is her second year with us at Rock Solid, and she graduated here at Friendship High School 2 years ago and is a student at Texas Tech right now, getting her degree in finance. And she does a little bit of everything at Rock Solid. She helps with gymnastics and dance and mostly littles. So we're thankful to have her part of our crew. Miss Molly Roberts is an important part of our dance crew. She is from Tyler, Texas, where she actually got 3 degrees from University of Texas in Tyler. She has a dance degree in health and kinesiology. So these people are not just dance teachers. They do all kinds of things. They love working with your kids. So we're blessed to have them as part of the crew. Molly has 2 beautiful little boys, one of them that's in the show tonight. So we're excited to have her as part of our group. And then finally, a little bit bittersweet, Miss Morgan Smith. This is actually her 5th year at Rock Solid, and we're sad to see her leave. This is her last night with us, but she'll always be Rock Solid family. We're excited for Miss Morgan. She just graduated from Tech, and we'll be moving home tomorrow to go back to Waco to finish planning her wedding. So she is about to become Mrs. Stratton, and we're really excited for her and looking forward to seeing her get married in October. So thanks again for coming. They are going to open up the show for us, and you guys give them a warm welcome and enjoy.
Our young hearts fade into the flood. down to the place we used to lay when we were kids. Memories of a stolen place, caught in the silence, an echo lost in space. It comes and goes in.
Things that happen when jealousy steps in and they start destroying things. And the story is that they all have to figure out how to work together to recreate beautiful things and to do good things for their new world and to figure out what their gifts are. So the verse that's on the back of your program, I'm going to read that to you. For as we have many members in one body, but all the members do not have the same functions. So we, being many, are one body in Christ and individually members of one another. Having then gifts differing according to the grace that is given to us, let us use them. Which is so true. We each have special gifts, and it's our job to figure out what they are and go use them for good. So make these guys feel welcome. They're nervous. The kids look beautiful. Don't they look beautiful?
Yeah.
I'm not sure that you guys want to see me tap dance or tell any jokes, so we're just going to chill for a little bit. Are y'all okay? Just being patient for a minute?
Yeah.
Okay, so sit back and enjoy the show. Thanks again for coming. And if you have your flashes on, we'd appreciate it if you could turn them off. Okay? Thanks, guys.
Our story begins in a world newly formed and completely empty, except for four wondrous beings. Each one was set apart and entrusted with a gift. The first was given power over earth, the second, water, the third, fire, and the last, air. And so they were named the Elements. These gifts would allow each element to help fill this new barren world with beautiful and unique creations. The elements were eager to use their gifts to start creating new things. They were so excited, they could hardly think of where to start. Until finally, Earth had a brilliant idea. Thank you. Earth's creation was amazing. It was small, yet so beautiful. The other elements marveled at its splendor. And so, the first creation was born, and it would be called a pebble. Earth wondered if she could make another one. Fire was so moved by Earth's creation that she wanted to try making something beautiful as well, something bright and warm. And so, the second creation was born, and it would be called Sunlight. Water saw the beauty of fire's gift and was inspired to create something too, but she wanted to make something soft and elegant. And so, the third creation was born, and it would be called Rain. Thank you. Air was in awe of her sister's creations, and she in turn desired to use her gifts. And so, the fourth creation was born, and it would be called Wind. The elements stepped back to see everything they had made. All of their creations were undeniably beautiful, yet something seemed to be missing. Maybe if they combined their gifts, they would be able to make something more meaningful. Individually, the elements possessed gifts that were special, but when working together, they had the potential to make something that none of them could create on their own. They had the ability to create life. And so, the first united creations were born, and they would be called flowers. Once the elements realized their potential when using their gifts in unison, they were eager to see just what else they could make. The flowers were beautiful, no doubt, but they wanted to create something bigger, more wondrous. And so, the trees were born. After they had made the trees, the elements looked around and were pleased with their creations. They had used their gifts to bring beauty, wonder, and life into a barren world. Many years passed, and the elements watched over the world they had made, always guarding their precious creations from harm. Until one day, water became envious of the other elements. She grew tired of her own gift, and instead wished she possessed their abilities. Her envy grew and grew, evolving into hatred. Until finally, her fury became uncontrollable. And it burst forth in the form of a monstrous flood. Saw what she had done, she was filled with shame. When air saw the power that water possessed, jealousy rose up inside of her. Air also desired to show the extent of her abilities. If water could use her power to create a flood, air would use hers to make a tornado. Saw what she had done, she was filled with shame. It wasn't long before Earth realized the extent of air and water's power. Turning a blind eye to the destruction her sisters had caused, she too desired to show the depth of her ability, no matter the consequences.
Thank you.
Elizabeth saw what she had done, she was filled with shame. When Fire saw the depth of her sister's power, she was filled with envy. If water, air, and earth could display such might, imagine what she could do. She gathered up all of the jealousy inside of her heart and ignited it into a wildfire that would cover every last corner of the world. When finally the wildfire had nothing left in this world to burn, Fire looked around and saw all that she had done. All of their beautiful creations were destroyed. Not one speck of life remained, and the world was barren once again. Fire thought of what she had done in her anger and her jealousy, and was overcome with shame. If only things could go back to the way that they were.
Thank you. vapor of it all. It's a chasing of the wind, the substance of the four. So pale and thin, let the veil of earth be stretched.
Oh,
back here so that you guys don't have to come to the stage to get your children. So they'll be heading this way. Give them just a few minutes to get prepared and get ready. We do have some cookies and punch in the lobby on your way out. And want to thank you guys for spending part of your weekend with us. Want to take this time to let you know that we do have some dance classes going on this summer. There's a contemporary class, a hip-hop class, the pop rocks, which is a little, and a ballet class, if you guys want to take classes in the summer. And then something very special that we have going on this summer that nobody else has is the week of June 17th is a special dance workshop that will encompass all kinds of dancing. Tap, jazz, hip-hop, theater, contemporary, some choreography. They'll be doing the whole shebang. So it's a good way for the kids to stay involved in the summer and try something different that they don't always get to do. So June 17th, if you guys will put that on your calendar and get signed up for that.